Using EquatiIO for remote learning is becoming increasingly popular. Let's take a look at how to use this EdTech tool to best maximize students and teachers creating STEM content in a digital setting. Open a Chrome browser window and go up to your Omnibox and type in EquatiIO.texthelp.com. This will steer users to your EquatiIO dashboard. I want to first take a look at the tabs to the left-hand side. Notice that the first tab is called Spaces. Now, as a teacher in my dashboard, I can see that I have several created assignments, or thumbnails, if you will, that are able to be sent to students to use for remote learning. So I have items like fraction wheels, finding volume, holiday activities, factoring trinomials, three-digit multiplication. So this took time to build all these thumbnails, but I'm going to show you as a teacher on how to use these thumbnails to send them to students for students to complete in a home learning environment. Let's take a look. Watch what happens when I click on a thumbnail. Let's try this Pi Day activity that I created yesterday. Take a look at the activity. The activity is asking students to complete the table up above. You may use any of the EquatiIO input methods in the toolbar to complete this activity. Go to the upper right-hand corner and you will see a circular blue share button. Go ahead and click on that share button. And I'm going to be given two options in my drop-down window. I can either A, make a copy for each student to complete, or B, make a copy for each person and expect a response. Because this is a remote learning demo, I'd like students to complete this and show that they understand the work, so I'm going to select option 2 because I want students to turn this in. I'm going to select that option, click continue, and EquatiIO will automatically generate this hyperlink for teachers to send to students. I have a couple options for sharing this. I can either A, copy this to my clipboard, and I can take this hyperlink and send this to students in any way that I typically share information to students, whether it be another EdTech tool, or maybe I want to use the EquatiIO integration of Google Classroom. This is totally up to you how you want to share this hyperlink. Let's walk you through the Google Classroom, though, because that I can demo for you. I'm going to select Google Classroom, and notice it will redirect me right to my Classroom Google account because I'm logged into my Chrome profile. I'm going to select the class that I want to send this to, and I'm going to send this to period 1. I'm then going to select in the dropdown, I'm going to create this as an assignment. Notice that when I create the assignment for this particular group, I select Go in the bottom right-hand corner, and automatically it will generate this link for you and your students. So I'm going to select the title, which will be Demo Remote Assignment, and I'm going to provide my students instructions, complete by the end of the week. And I can come over here and select the due date, which Google Calendar will open up here to the right-hand side, and maybe I want to give them 2 days to complete. And I can also leave this blank, or it'll just automatically default to midnight on that particular day. So I'm going to go ahead and click off of here, and I'm going to assign this math space to my students. So it says you have posted to your class. I can then view this assignment. And notice that I, in this instance, need to invite students to my class. Hopefully, your Google Classroom is already set up. So it'll notify students that I've posted a new assignment, and my students will be able to click from Google Classroom to enter that math space. With that being said, I'm going to show you now what this looks like from the student perspective. So I'm going to copy that URL. I'm going to open a totally different Google account here. And I want to show you what this is going to look like from the student side. When students click on that hyperlink, however you shared it or within Google Classroom, they will get their own personalized copy of this math space that you created so they can complete this at home. I also can see here the difference in the top right corner. I no longer have the ability to share this because that was under the teacher dashboard, and now I am showing you the demo from the student side. So from the student's perspective, I need to submit this back to my teacher. So let's go ahead and use the EquatiIO tools here at the bottom, whichever tools students would like to use. I can use my graph editor, my handwriting, my speech. I can use mobile. I can annotate with freehand drawing if I want, and I can go ahead and write out the formula for the area of a circle. So once I start to fill this in, students would then have the opportunity to solve these problems once they know this formula. I could, of course, always go to my equation editor and search for the area, and I can find the area of a circle. So this is if I didn't want my students to use their handwriting, because that can sometimes be challenging to read that, and I can insert that formula as opposed to handwriting it as well. Now for these examples, I would want my students to show their work, so I could write the work underneath, I could resize these images, but ultimately I want students to go ahead and fill in this table. Now from a time standpoint, I'm not going to actually solve these problems, but I would like to show you what this looks like from the student side, and then go back to the teacher side to show you how you can score this from the teacher perspective. So I'm going to submit this assignment back to my teacher and pretend that I've completed it. Notice you get a congratulations message with a little text helper celebrating there. I'm going to acknowledge that and click OK. I'm going to go back to my teacher dashboard. Now remember, this is my teacher thumbnail. So I'm going to go back to the actual dashboard here. And notice that when I originally showed this at the beginning of this demo, I can access these other tabbed items, which I'm going to demo for you now. As a teacher, I need to see what assignments have been turned in. So I am going to click on my assignments tab. Once I click on my assignments tab, I will see assignments that have been turned in to me. Notice this one has been turned in and I've received one copy or one response of this assignment. And notice that it's named, so it'll display the student name. It'll also be timestamped. And once I click on this assignment, I can go in and provide on-the-spot feedback and send this right back to the student at home if they've missed particular questions. So let's say, for example, this student actually just filled in the formula and didn't solve the problems or fill in the table. I, as the teacher, I'm looking at the feedback view here. And I can go in and leave my students' feedback. So I'm going to go and open my equation editor as the teacher. I'm going to insert text in here, and I'm going to say, Louis, please fill in the table and resubmit when finished. And I'm going to insert that into the math space here. And I can, let me put that where I can see all the text here. So the student, when they see it, will be able to see that. And I will go and notice here, I can now send this back to the student. So once I send this back to the student would then, let me show you, I'm going to go back to that student account. They probably more than likely, if their Chrome notifications are turned on, will receive a pop-up message in the bottom right corner. And it'll say, Mr. Schanefelt has submitted this assignment back to you to resubmit. So the student can then open that from the notification pane and do this assignment once again. So this is all great, but one thing I also want to show you is, let's say the student wants to see that assignment that they've submitted. Well, this right here is a submitted assignments tab. So for a student, they can click on this, and they would have access to the assignments that they've previously submitted to the teacher. So this I would like for you to think of as the student dashboard in math space. And then finally, your last tab here is your archive spaces. your archive spaces, or any of the spaces on the original teacher dashboard in tab 1 that you don't really need anymore. So I can archive this space, for example. Acknowledge that, click OK, and they will be saved here for you. So this is a very quick, brief intro as to how we can utilize EquatiIO from a remote learning standpoint, and students will then be able to communicate and have a digital workflow back and forth with their teacher if they're using a remote learning environment. I hope this demonstration has helped ease some of the trouble that teachers have in being able to communicate with students and sharing and maintaining a digital workflow in terms of STEM and math content in a digital technology environment.